Very good morning, students. Welcome back to second year physics. In this second year physics, in the previous, actually we completed about a mutual induction and as well as the self induction related problems and related applications are over. What I want to say about a AC generator. That mean here, actually we have AC generator and as well as the DC generator, both we have. So in this first one, I want to say about AC generator, because in our syllabus we have only AC generator, not with the DC. The DC is there in the 10th class. Of course, this AC generator is designed by Nikola Tesla. In general, AC generator is designed by Nikola Tesla. And here come to the point is, AC generator is a machine which produces the AC energy. It is in a device, the device which produces the AC energy from mechanical energy. That means mechanical is nothing but a what? There should be some work is done. That mechanically work is done. Therefore, the mechanical energy, from the mechanical energy, AC energy is to be generated. That's what we can call AC generator. That we can call as the alternate currents. By using a generator, we can produce as the alternate currents. That's what we can call AC. AC is nothing but alternate currents. So now come to the point is, I want to say, in this AC generator, by using this AC generator, actually mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy. This is the very, very important. That electrical energy is nothing but what we can say, AC energy it is. Now, in this, usually, by using this modern generator, this is used to produce the typical value of 100 megawatts. See, by using a mechanical energy, this may produce as the typical power, that is around 100 megawatts can be produced. Which one? This generated, AC generated, can be used to produce the megawatt. See, it is typical to produce the modern generator. Now come to the point is, sir, this generated, what is the principle? How it is works and what is the diagram is there. I'll tell you, in this AC generator, actually we will discuss only essential parts. So this is consist of a essential parts, sir. One is field magnets. Sir, what is field magnet? That we can say horseshoe magnet or field magnet usually produces electromagnetic or magnetic field. And this AC generator is which works on the principle of mutual induction. That mean you, there is a, or electromagnetic induction, we can also call electromagnetic induction. Let I want to say, it is consist of a field magnets, say look at, which are we can call as the north, south of a bar magnet, you say north, it is a one magnet, one magnetic pole. You take another magnetic pole, see, another one you say south, yes, which is to be, we can call as the field magnets. Right, south pole. Usually this north and south is produces the magnetic field, and it is the radial magnetic field which produces. This is the first essential part is required. And between the two poles, there will be a field produced by the two magnetic fields or magnetic field, field magnets. And in between this, there is a coil is suspended. That is a rectangular coil, we can say. A rectangular coil, so that a rectangular coil of PQ length, PQRS is the rectangular coil, and which usually it is, with the help of an axle, that coil can be rotated, so that this is we can call as the coil, and this coil is rotates on the basis of axle. You call axle it is, axle in the sense is like a rod. About that rod, this coil is rotates. And now come to the point is, this coil is connected to the two slip rings. This is will be two slip rings, clear? And it is a one slip ring, and you take one more slip ring, right? This is to be, we can call two slip rings. Rings, okay, and these two slip rings are connected to carbon brushes. This is we can call, these two are we can call as the carbon brush, right? And this is to be connected to output. Here you get the AC. Clear? Now this is the diagram we can call about a AC generator. In this AC generator, there are essential parts are, we require a field magnets. In between the field magnet, there is a rectangular coil is connected, P, Q, R, S, and these two ends are connected. One end is connected to the slip ring, and another end is connected to the another slip ring. And these two slip rings are connected to the carbon brushes. And here from the carbon brush, we'll get the output. That is, we can say alternate current, or we can also write as alternate EMF. Clear? See, from this only we'll get the alternate EMF. Now how it is works? Of course, I told you very clear, it is works on the principle of mutual induction. That mean here mutual induction is nothing but a, as long as the flux changes, the flux is linked with the coil, therefore there it is to be current and EMF is induces. So that I want to say, whenever the amount of magnetic flux linked with the coil, the change in magnetic flux linked with the coil, therefore in the coil the current and EMF is induces. Now what I want to say, there is a very very important is, this is the coil and it is an axle. So now let us this axle is rotated. If I say this axle is rotated like this, therefore the coil will rotate it to be like this. When coil is rotates in a given a field, there will be a field is changes. That means the coil is linked with the field because of the coil is rotating in the given a field. When it is rotating in the given a field, there it is to be current and EMF is induces because of the coil rotating about an axle. That means I'll show you like this. You take, it is a coil one, then it is rotating like this in a given a field. Therefore what happens, it is rotating like this, then the flux is linked with the coil is changes. When the flux is linked with the coil is changes, there it is to be EMF is induces in the coil, or the current is induces in the coil. There it is, the EMF is will get output from the this slip rings and as well as the carbon brushes, and these wires are connected to useful work done in our consumption. We can use from this getting the energy or AC energy, or we can say alternate current. Come to the point. So usually when the coil is rotating in the given a field, no, there it is to be mechanical work is done. That mechanical work is it is done, therefore that mechanical energy is converted as the AC energy or alternate currents. So this we can call as the AC generator. So remember everyone, here the main essential parts are field magnets, rectangular coil, or we can also call armature, and it is axle. This is a line, and there are two slip rings, and as well as the carbon brushes are connected. Now by using this, now we need to find electromagnetic or EMF we need to find. So that here I'll tell you first thing, we know as long as the flux changes, that flux is linked with the coil, no? Therefore flux is equal to BAN actually cos theta. We need to find EMF, that is minus d phi by dt. So now EMF we need to get. Before that I'll tell you, here theta is nothing but you write as omega, then flux is equal to, it is BAN cos omega t, of course. So here you write E is equal to minus d by dt of BAN cos omega t. Now let us you take any differentiation of cos omega t, because with respect to t here is then, with respect to time is there, therefore we may get the E is equal to minus BAN cos omega t d by dt of, you write as cos omega t. Now you take E is equal to minus BAN cos omega t is nothing but a minus sin omega t into omega, then E is equal to BAN omega sin omega t. So this is we can call alternate currents. See, from this end directly this is connected to the next chapter, that is alternate currents only. Next chapter is alternate currents. So from this equation where we are ending this, then it is to be starting for the next chapter. So before that, here we need to get like here. Suppose theta is equal to omega is equal to omega t is equal to, if I take a 90, 90 in the sense is there will be a, what happens here, E is equal to BAN omega sin 90, sin 90 is 1, so E is equal to BAN omega. This is we can call maximum value of EMF, maximum value of EMF. Therefore, here we'll get the, here you write E is equal to E naught sin omega t. This is alternate EMF. See, when here E BAN omega represented as the E naught, no, E naught is represented as maximum value, peak value, peak, or we can also call crest, C-R-E-S-T, crest, peak or maximum. This is RMS, we can call RMS, root mean square value. Root mean square value at a particular time, the strength of the EMF, it is E is equal to E naught sin omega t. See, it is represented as sin, no? Therefore, sin represented is nothing but a graph. If I take sine wave graph, I think everyone know about a sine wave. So I'll show you the sine wave also, because the graph is very, very important in this case. Right, now let us the graph, I'll show you. Yeah, from this graph, so we can take like this. This graph is, because it started like this, no? Yes, it is a sine wave. E is equal to E naught sin omega t. And time is taken, and E is taken on y-axis. So in this we can say maximum value is E naught. And the time, if I take, it is T by 4, T by 2, and 3T by 4 it is. And it is capital T. This is the full cycle we can call. From origin to this, in a time 0 to capital T. 0 to capital T represented as a full cycle. Full cycle of EMF. So you say full cycle of EMF is from origin to this. This is we can call half cycle, and it is a call full half cycle. It is a plus half, it is a minus half. This is represented as when it is started from origin, therefore represented as like this. Suppose if I want to write a alternate currents also, yes, I is equal to I naught sin omega t, there it is to be like this, right? So you say it is E, it is right. And I mean ER, we can say I. So again it is I naught represented, it is T by 4 it is, and T by 2 it is, and it is 3T by 4, and it is T. So I is equal to I naught sin omega T, we can say like this. So these two expressions are related to what? Sine wave expression, sine wave graph. So this about a this chapter, and it is which started from origin. Suppose if I say, if I say the coil is rotated, I want to say like this. If it is started from extreme position, that mean here T is equal to 0, then there we can take as the omega T plus pi by 2. So the flux value, if I take like this, instead of taking second case, I am telling now, say flux is equal to BAN cos it is omega t plus pi by 2. If I take like this, cos omega t plus pi by 2, therefore there will get the EMF will be E naught it is cos omega t will get. See, if represented as cos, therefore there may be a graph, because in terms of cos is there, the graph represented as from extreme like this. You say it is T by 4, this we can say T by 2, this is 3T by 4, and it is T. So time is taken, and here I, or we can say E is taken. Suppose I want to say I is equal to I naught cos omega T also we can take. So both, because E and EMF, or I is equal to I naught, we can say like this, clear? So that it is represented as what it is, about a EMF when it is started from extreme position, then graph will be represented like this. When it is started from origin, the graph will be represented to be like this. So these two graphs are very, very important for the next chapter. Of course, again there in the next chapter also, that is alternate currents. Clear? On this basis, I want to say some problems and conclusions from this chapter. I'll tell you, because almost chapter is over now. So that's what I'll tell you, conclusions, and as well as the if any problems are there, then we'll do it, then we'll finish it the chapter. Electromagnetic induction, right? So once open the materials, yeah, there is a question is there on the basis of this 271 page number. Once open the 271 page number, describe the working of AC generator with the aid of simple diagram and necessary expressions, so that you go through the same which I was given here. There are two fieldings, field magnets, and there is a coil is suspended, a slip rings, and as well as a carbon brushes, alternate EMF is producing. Once you go through this diagram, clear? Everyone look at this diagram. So which I was given on the board. There on the basis of necessary, yeah, graphs also given. Go through the graph which is given in this. Clear? Okay. See, from this chapter previously, the questions are given as in the previous question papers, if you check. So there are questions are given, what are eddy currents, describe the ways in which they are used with advantages. It is one question given in the previous exam, the previous IPE. Define self-induction and mutual inductions. This question was also given. And a self-induction of a coil, arrive at an expression for the induced EMF in a coil and the rate of change of current in it. It is also given in the previous exam. And as well as the current in a coil changes from 5 ampere to 10 ampere, already we did this. It is not over. So better you do this question, one problem on the basis of a mutual induction. Yeah. See the page number, 282 page number, question number 4. This question was given in the year of March 2009. In IPE it is given, so better you do this. Look at the current in a coil changes from 5 ampere to 10 ampere. So page number 282, question number is 4. So current I1 is equal to 5 ampere, I2 is equal to 10 ampere, in DT is equal to 10 power minus 2 seconds. Then EMF 50 millivolts induced. The EMF is given 50 millivolt. Small m, no milli. So 50 into 10 power minus 3 volt. This is E. Calculate the mutual induction. Capital M is asking. So there is a capital M is equal to, or else we can say E is equal to M into DI by DT, of course. Right? This question is very, very important, because this question is given in the previous question. So E is equal to M, mutual induction, that is 50 into 10 power minus, is asking capital M, no? Better you write in terms of capital M. E is given 50 into 10 power minus 3 DI, change in current, that is asking M, no? 10 minus 5 by DT is 10 power minus 2. So 50 into 10 power minus 3 into 10 power minus 2 by 2 is equal, 5 minus 5 it is capital M, 5 ones, 5 tens. So better you cancel, this is 10 power minus 4 Henry, or we can say 10 power minus 1 milli Henry mH, or 0.1 milli H. Clear? So like this one question is given in the previous exam, right? Yeah, there is another question. In very short answers, you look at once. Not only in very very short answers, I mean to say page number 266. Page number 266, question number 11. Right. Page number 266, question number 11. 266. Question number is 11. See, Kamal pedals a stationary bicycle. The pedal of a bicycle are attached to a 100 turn of a coil of area. So there will be a number of turns are given, 100 turns. Area is given as 0.10 meter square. The coil rotates at a half revolution per second. So that the frequency is given 1/2, or we can say 0.5 revolution per second. That means here per second is, we can take as the hertz, right? And it is placed in a uniform magnetic field. There will be a capital B, 0.01 Tesla is given. Perpendicular to the axis of rotation of the coil, what is the maximum voltage generated in the coil? Of course, so E is equal to, we can write as BAN omega, because maximum, no? Just now I told you that is E is equal to BAN omega cos, sin theta, no? Theta is given as 90, no? So that, or we can say omega t it is. We can also write as omega t. So you write here omega t, then it is BAN omega. This is will be maximum, E naught you say. Here you write this E naught value, because substitute here, E naught is equal to B is 0.01, area of coil is 0.10 into N number of turns into frequency, no, omega instead of omega 2 pi n f r n, your wish. Therefore 2 pi n, so E naught is equal to 0.01 into 0.10, okay, into 100 into 2 into 3.14, frequency is 0.5. so suppose you multiply this, you will get the final answer, the maximum value when it is perpendicular. Right, when it is perpendicular, we'll get the maximum answer will be E is equal to, suppose if you take a multiplication, approximately 0.314 volt. See, you multiply this, then we'll get the like this. Suppose 0.01 into 100, no? Then we'll get the 0.12 into this. So we may get the, it is 826 into 0.5. Then after simplification, we'll get the 0.314. So this is the question related on the basis of AC generated or alternate currents. So this chapter is over, and this is to be connected to the next chapter direct, that is alternate currents. So that we'll meet in the new chapter with alternate currents. Thank you very much. Thank you.